Gary, I did that for your benefit. There's an expression, and I've been known to say it. You know, I'm a very humble person. The humblest person I know. And one of the things that I often am fond of saying is, I am God's gift to the world. Let me say it again. I am God's gift to the world. They said, it's the Me Too movement. Is there another Me Too? Come on, everybody raise your hand. You are God's gift to the world. And today in the gospel, we read about Philip who meets Jesus. And immediately he wants to go tell his buddy about it. His buddy's name is God's gift to the world, otherwise known as Nathaniel. Now, I haven't checked it out yet, but I believe that means God's gift, because Nathan in Hebrew, which I remember from my Hebrew classes, means give, and El is oftentimes God. Laura, as a seminarian, I want you to check that out and do a fact check. You think I got it? How? 1 point. So, Nathaniel's very name is God's gift. And in the song today, which we're going to talk about, the psalmist is saying, God, you knew me before I was born. You know me better than my parents know me. And I am a gift to the world. So if you don't forget anything else, and we will forget a lot that I said, can you say you are God's gift to what? Who? Oh, I love it. She said, God's gift to God. Wow, you are absolutely right. We're not only God's gift to the world, but we are at our best when we're God's gift to God, when we offer ourselves to God. Thank you. You are being raised up in the wisdom of God. Thank you, Laura. Now y'all can head to Children's Chapel.